angels, I hope you're all doing well today. So in today's video, we are doing a huge subscription box unboxing. I have three different subscription boxes to unbox with you today. So if you want to see everything that came inside my subscription boxes for the month of July, just keep watching. We are in a different location in my condo today. Let me know how you like this background versus my other background. We have a lot of plants going on here. I'm sitting among my plants. It's also much cooler out here, and it is very hot in Calgary today. So it is cooler here with the AC, so I wanted to film out here today. Let me know how you like this setup. Now, before we jump into our unboxing, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below if you are new to my channel. I would love to have you as part of our YouTube family, and it is completely free. Another thing that's free is giving this video a big thumbs up and hitting that bell notification next to the subscribe button, and that will actually notify you every time I upload. So every time I upload a video, YouTube will let you know if you hit that bell button. So go ahead and hit the bell, subscribe, and give it a thumbs up, and let's go ahead and get started. Today I have not one, not two, but three subscription boxes to unbox for you. So I have my Ipsy Glam Bag for the month of July. I also have my BoxyCharm Premium. As you can see, someone was very rough with this box. This just arrived. I have not even opened it yet. Hopefully we can get it open okay and nothing is damaged inside. But this is my All True box, also known as Cosbox. So they have now renamed themselves All True instead of Cosbox. So if you receive any of these subscriptions, let me know in the comments if we received the same items or different items and if you were happy with your boxes. Now I've lost my scissors. Let's go ahead and unbox our Ipsy first. This is the least expensive subscription of the three. This is just the Ipsy Glam Bag because that's the only one you can get in Canada, unfortunately, just their smallest subscription. I don't really understand why we can't get the Ipsy Plus and the Ipsy X. Someone let me know if you know why we can't get those in Canada. But I just get the Ipsy Glam Bag, which is their smallest subscription. And the theme for the month is Stay Golden, which it says on the bag here. The bag also has this really cute little zipper. So let's see what we have inside. I have to say this is one of the nicer Ipsy bags we have received. And of course we do get a card which lets us know a little bit more about each item. So the first thing we have here is an MOTD brush. This is the Lightning Crew brush. So this is a highlight brush. I don't know if I necessarily use this for highlight. I might use this for powder setting under my eyes. I don't know. This isn't usually the shape of brush I'd use for highlight, but that is what it's supposed to be used for. I do like this brand of brushes. It is very soft, and I'm always happy to receive brushes in our subscription boxes because I feel like I can never have enough brushes. Next item we have here is from Neogen Dermatology. I've never heard of them. This is the White Truffle Serum in Oil Drop. So this contains white truffles. It says morning and night apply 2 to 3 drops into clean skin and massage. So I think it's just a facial oil. We do just get a small size here. Next we have another skincare item, and I believe this is from a Canadian brand. This is from Three Ships, and I received their lip mask in one of my Cos boxes back when it was still called Cos Box, and I love the lip mask. It's fantastic. So I've been seeing this brand more and more, and I believe they are Canadian, which we love. So this is their Purify Aloe and Amino Acid Cleanser. This would be a great size for traveling. And next we have an item we see quite a bit in subscription boxes. This is the First Aid Beauty Coconut Skin Smoothie Priming Moisturizer. I've used this many times. This is a really nice primer, especially if you do have dry skin. Now, the last item in our Ipsy bag is one I actually got to choose. This is from Koki Cosmetics, and the reason I chose this is because it's not easy to get your hands on Koki Cosmetics here in Canada, and so I thought I would choose this long wear liquid eyeliner from Koki. And I've heard really good things about the brand from people here on YouTube, so I'm excited to try this one out. So I did spend about $18 Canadian total on this bag after the currency conversion and shipping and taxes. So let me know in the comments, do you think this was worth the $18? Let me know if you get Ipsy and if we received the same items or different. Water break. You should take a water break too. The next box we are opening is my BoxyCharm Premium for the month of July. Now this is not just any BoxyCharm, this is a BoxyCharm Takeover box. If you remember last year, they had a Fenty Takeover box. This year, they have a Norvina and Anastasia Beverly Hills box. Let me know in the comments if you are signed up for BoxyCharm Premium. Now we have a big card here letting us know everything that came inside the box and its values. And we also have a code here. So if you want to use code ABHXBOXY, you can get 50% off their website. I will not be using that code, but go ahead and use it if there's something you have your eye on their website. The first thing we have in the box is this Norvina Pro Pigment Palette. Now I'm sure people were really excited to get this one. I think this one's about $50 or $60 Canadian. I can actually tell you. So the MSRP on this one is $60. This is a pricey palette. You get a lot of different colors. And if you're someone who loves playing with color on your eyes, I think you would really love to receive these palettes in your box. I do have the orangey version already. I forget which number that is, but I do not have this one. And I do believe we got to choose which palette we received in our box. So I did choose this one because I do not have it yet. The next item we have in the box is the ABH Lash Brag Mascara in the full size. This is valued at $25. Now this whole box retails for $35 US. So I paid $35 US for this box. Let me know in the comments if you think it was worth it. I usually do find my premium box to be worth it. That's why I've been getting it for years. I get the premium box and the base box and I pay for them both myself. So this is what the Lash Brag Mascara looks like. Now this is a very weighted tube. I have not tried this mascara, at least I don't think I've tried it. It's always nice to get mascaras in subscription boxes. I feel like everyone can get some use out of them. The next item we received is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Shimmer Body Oil. This is valued at $35 US. I haven't heard a lot of people talk about this or rave about it. Let me know if you've tried this. That's probably why it ended up in BoxyCharm, because no one bought it. But let me know if you've tried it. I'm not sure if there's a scent to this one, but this is what it looks like, and it comes in this glass container. The next item is a liquid lipstick from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I feel like a lot of people really love their liquid lipsticks and they were really popular for a while. So we received this in the shade Heathers, which looks like it's some sort of red shade. This is valued at $20 US. So this is a very beautiful red. I think this will be so gorgeous for the fall and winter. We have two more items in our box. The premium box usually comes with 6 to 7 full-size items. Next, we have the ABH Powder Bronzer, and I think I got to choose this one. This is in the shade Rosewood, and the value on this one is $28. Now, I'm not sure how this will look on my skin tone. It looks a little bit cool-toned, but this was the best from the choice I had. So I chose Rosewood. Now anything I don't think I'll get use out of or isn't really suited to me, I will always put on my Poshmark. I will leave my Poshmark link down below. The last item in our BoxyCharm is the Brow Definer. Now the only problem with this is look at the shade they sent me. So they sent me the shade Dark Brown, even though they know that's not my shade and I did all my quizzes and everything, but you know, sometimes things happen and they send the wrong shade. So this will definitely end up on my Poshmark because this will definitely be too dark for my brows. As you can tell, I do not have dark brown hair or brows. So that is everything that came inside our BoxyCharm Premium for the month of July. Let me know in the comments, was this worth it? Did you get BoxyCharm Premium? Did you like your box? Did you not like your box? Let me know. And last but not least, we have our very beat up All True box. So let me see if I can get this open. So, oh my goodness. The whole box is falling apart here. Oh, and it still says Cosbox. Okay, so it says peel here. I'm guessing if you peel, it says All True. So I've been getting this box on and off for a few years. I find their shipping very, very slow. It takes a long time for them to ship out boxes, so that's why I canceled, but then I ended up getting it again so I could unbox it here on YouTube. So let me know, do you get Cosbox, and how do you feel about their customer service and shipping? I feel like they have very, very poor customer service from what I've experienced. We get this guide to summer. So this tells us about the items in the box, similar to the magazine in FabFitFun. And the thing about Cosbox, if you didn't know, is they try really hard to be sustainable and eco-friendly and get items that are made fairly as well. So this is what this looks like here. It opens like a map, so we can see what we received and also what other people received. So I will put this here. Now this is a complete surprise for me. I did not get to choose any of my items because I am a seasonal member, and they opened up choice to seasonal members, but only after my box had shipped, even though it hadn't shipped. So I didn't get to choose. I don't know, it was just a mess. Again, I have not had the best luck with CosBox. All true, I should say. But anyway, I did not choose any of these items. My tissue paper is completely ripped. It looks like a raccoon got into it. But let's see what's inside. So the first thing we have here are the set of four waffle dish towels with canvas holder. Okay, so they come with a canvas bag here. And it doesn't say the value, so that sucks. Usually it says the values. Okay, so we get four different dish towels. These actually look like really nice dish towels, and I'll probably get some good use out of these. I try to use dish towels like this for cleaning up instead of paper towel, just because it's better for the environment, and then you just throw these in the washing machine. Now, I'm guessing, oh, okay. Okay, that's really cute. I like the holder better than the dishcloths, because that is adorable. You could even put a plant in there. Okay, look at this. Like, that is adorable. Okay, we're leaving that like that. My little cactus has a little bag. That's really cute. I'm leaving that like that. Okay, so I'm happy with the dishcloths. Is it exciting? Not really. Is it practical? Yes. Next, we have a skincare item in our box. This is the bakuchiol. I'm not sure how to say this. You know what I mean. It's a retinol alternative. Hard to pronounce, not sure how to pronounce it. This is from Cosmetics skincare brand. We see them quite a bit in subscription boxes. And there is, I don't know why I'm looking at this, because there's no value. We have a hair product here, brand with a heart, it's called. I do love the color of the packaging. Love pink packaging. This is a leave-in conditioning blend. So because I have very dry and damaged hair, I'm always looking to try new leave-in conditioners. So this is a win for me. Oh. So the options here were a packable hammock, which I really wanted to get because I love a hammock and I just think that I would get more use out of, or a travel cutlery set. Like, that is not a fair trade in my opinion. A travel cutlery set or a hammock? Of course I'd rather get the hammock. I think, you know what? I'll give this to my fiance to use at work, I guess, to take to work with him. This is what the cutlery set looks like here. Just looks like basic cutlery. So basically they're just trying to eliminate single-use products. You're supposed to bring this around with you instead of using plastic knives and forks, which is a really good idea, but I wish I would have got the hammock instead. The hammock is such a better option. This next item everyone received. This is a set of three lip balms, Hannah Lay Company. I believe we've seen this in Ipsy before. You get three lip balms in here. Good if you're always losing your lip balms like me. So you get these lip balms here. You get an unscented version, boring, but unscented if you're allergic to fragrance, tropical citrus, and Island Mint. I'll probably like the Island Mint one best. I love mint lip products. Okay, so we have that. And our last item. So I think this is the big item of the box. You could either get a set of five bowls, a cooler tote, which I wish I would have received that, a cooler tote for drinks and things, or what I received, which is an oversized roundy towel. So, let's see here. This is what it looks like. I do like the colors. This might be good for taking to the beach or picnics. This will be really nice for taking to the park. When I go to the park with the dogs, Ralph always likes to lay down with me, so this will be really nice for him to lay on. It's actually quite big, and it feels just like a towel. So that's nice. I'm happy with that. I feel like that was our big item of the box. So what do I think of the box? It's okay. I'd probably rate it a 6 out of 10 or a 5 out of 10. I'm not impressed about the cutlery just because I already have cutlery and I could just bring it with me if I wanted to. I do love the dish towels. I like these and I love the little case they came in. The serum I probably won't use, the leave-in conditioner I will use, and the lip balms are just okay. So let me know, what do you think of this All True box? And you get All True. And let me know which of the subscriptions you think won for this month. So what was the best subscription? Cosbox, BoxyCharm, or Ipsy? Let me know in the comments. Now, if you like this type of video where I do a collective video of all my subscription boxes I receive for the month, please let me know in the comments so that I know to keep doing them this way. I feel like this is a lot easier for me to not have to edit three separate videos. I can just do them all in one. However, they will come later in the month because I have to wait for them all to get here. So definitely let me know if you like this type of video, and of course, give it a thumbs up before you leave. As always, thank you all so much for watching. It really does mean the world to me, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.